Good morning and welcome to a day in the life of a Harvard computer science philosophy student generally. Essentially this morning I have my first class at 9. It's sales at Harvard Business School, which is funny because that's not what I study. But what's nice is you can kind of like cross register pretty easily. I've just, you know, brushed my teeth, got ready, made some coffee, and yeah, time to get started with the day. This is my setup. Got my agenda, which is my life, laptop, and then, you know, iPad, which you actually need if you're writing formulas for your math classes. I'm someone who lives by the literal book, so I essentially just plan out like every hour of my day and what needs to be done by then. Presumably part of the reason you're watching this is because you want to see campus and campus life. And trust me, I would love to show you that too if it wasn't, you know, coronavirus times. So I hope that you still get like a taste of academic life and like tidbits of what the typical day looks like, even if unfortunately, you know, things are insane outside. This is the Stat 110 PSET. I'm almost done. It's like, you know, 7 questions, our intro to probability and statistics class. Anyways.
The downside is it exploded corn across.
Yep. Nick and I are making roasted pork belly with corn and spinach and rice for lunch. We pre-plan all our meals so that we don't eat pasta every day. And it's looking pretty good.
Like, it might look like we're eating charcoal, but we're actually, I promise it tastes good.
I actually transferred from NYU, so I spent my first 2 years at NYU studying business and political economy, and then I transferred to Harvard, where I now study computer science and philosophy, and I'm doing what should be like a 4-year degree in 2.5 years, so I'm like putting all my classes in just heavier semesters. Also, if you, like, depending on what you study, you'll have more homework just sort of like by virtue of how much homework those classes give. So for example, in computer science, the average class says, according to our Q guide, which is like where students give comments about classes and give like data about classes, it is like approximately 10 to 12 hours of homework outside of your lectures and sections and stuff. And so obviously if you're taking a lot of computer science classes like I am, or like a lot of like classes in the engineering department or stats department or something like that, you're just going to have many hours of homework. It's nice because even if you miss a class because the time zone's super weird or something, you can always just rewatch the lectures. Oh, and also our mascot, I guess, for this class, I feel like all CS classes have a mascot, is the really cute Hello Kitty. Looks good. It is now 8:16, done with all my classes and section for the day, and essentially what I have left is homework for this cool like systems class where the PSET is about this, I don't know, it's something to do with assembly and you have to like not have this bomb go off, something to do with that. I haven't started it yet. And then at 9 o'clock, I had this meeting for Interact, which is like a fellowship for technologists. You essentially go camping in the woods in northern San Francisco, and you talk about like technology in the world, which is cool. And then the rest of my night, I have to do some readings for HBS. We're doing a case on Tesla, and then the former COO of Tesla is joining us as a guest tomorrow, so I should probably, you know, really read that case. And then finally, I'm doing readings for this independent study that I'm doing with a professor at the college, where we're talking about the history of technology, which is super cool. We're essentially just reading like these really old articles from like, okay, old in the world of like CS. So like articles from 1940s and 50s and 60s up until now that really were the foundations of computer science. On campus, after dinner, you would have like office hours or you would go to meetings, and then we have something called brain break where people bring out snacks like cookies and celery and things like that to keep your brain going for the late night of studying.
So I think that's going to be it for me today. I am exhausted and I'm going to sleep. Obviously, you know, I guess my parting thoughts are like, this is not what every day looks like. And in particular during school, there's a lot more walking and they see a lot more bumping into people and talking and just kind of like a balanced life. I think, unfortunately, like one of the things that the coronavirus and being at home and being really lucky incentivizes is that you can just kind of focus in on whatever you're doing, whether that's school or work, and do that all day because there's really no separation between this and your normal life or like your social life or any other life. So yeah, it's just, this is what like the snapshot of like October 2020 looks like. And hopefully it's been interesting seeing and capturing a moment in time like this. And I hope you are all staying safe and getting good sleep. It's really important.